Today we're going to convert this plain terracotta pot into a beautiful gift, and we're going to use glue, acrylic paint and a paper napkin. This lovely napkin is called Blossoms, and it comes from Ninny's Napkins. There is a discount code and a link in the description below this video which gives you a discount for your first purchase with Ninny's Napkins. We're going to take 8 simple steps now to decorate this pot. Step 1, we're going to paint the bottom of the pot with white acrylic paint. I just use a filbert brush to do that. And we just cover the whole area below the rim. As you can see, it's not real even. You can see the brush strokes and the pot through it. So you'll need more than one coat to get this a nice even coverage. Now I'm going to use a sponge, and I've chosen the finer one of the two, to give the last coat on the pot. This gives it a slightly textured finish, but not too rough. And it gives it an even all over white finish. We're now going to separate all the pieces of the napkin that we want to use on the pot, and I'm just using a size 2 liner brush and water. I hold the napkin on the edge that I'm going to be keeping and pull slightly, and it comes away quite easily. I usually cut out more than I need. That can go into my scrap bin for later, whatever I don't use. But you're better off having more than you need, because then you can manipulate things to fit the area that you want. I test it out first to see how it looks, and as I was going to start gluing them on, I realized that there's an awful lot of white hanging off the edge of some of these pieces, so I've gone back with a liner brush and I'm just relieving those pieces of the excess white paper. Now that I've got all my pieces ready, I have watered down my Mod Podge because I like to put the napkin in position and then add the Mod Podge on top, and with it a thinner consistency, it soaks through the napkin really easily. Once it's dried, I would come back again and put a second coat on the top so that I know that there's plenty of glue holding that napkin down. I'm going to trim a little bit of this leaf off. It's going to overlap the other leaf slightly, but the other leaf is lighter, so it's not going to show through. And then I'm going to trim a little bit of the flower off on the left also. I'll just cut it with a pair of scissors so that it doesn't overlap the flower beside it. Make sure you get all the napkin, even the white bits, glued down securely. Double check where you've been, and then that where it folds under the pot, it needs to be definitely have extra glue on there. And I've also coated the whole surface, the white surface that didn't have glue on it. I'm putting glue on that too, so that the whole thing looks even and consistent. Now you just leave that to dry. And then once that's dry, you come back with a complementary color, a color that goes well with that napkin, and I'm painting the rim. Now the rim, I paint the under part of the rim first by turning the pot upside down and going around that edge. And then I turn it over and I'm going doing the side of the rim, as you can see, getting a good thick coverage there. I think I go over that about twice in order to make sure it's an even coat. And I also do the top of the rim, but that's an optional extra. You don't have to do that top bit there. It's up to you. Some people go down inside to that first bump inside. As you can see, there's a ledge there. Some people paint down to that ledge. But I like some terracotta showing. Now I'm now giving a second coat to the side of that pot, just to make sure it's an even color all over. Now here's the pot finished. And the last thing I would do, and I'm not showing it in this video, is to either pick a matte or a gloss sealer to go over the top of that. And I would coat it inside and out, and that would protect the napkin and the paint. Check out my other napkin videos that are appearing on the screen now. You might find some more interesting projects to have a play with.